To whom shall we go? Your words, O Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of eternal life. Good morning, my family in Christ. How are you doing today? Is everything all right? Another brand new Sunday has just begun. And let's say thank you to the Lord for another opportunity to be alive again for this wonderful Sunday. Let's surrender our day to Him. Let's surrender ourselves to Him. Let's give our lives at His feet. And once we give our life to Him, there is no way to get it back. Lord, take care of everything. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Today, let's finish the sequence of Jesus being the bread of life. We've been reflecting upon Jesus being the bread of life for the last 4 Sundays. And today, we are going to reflect upon the reaction of the disciples of Jesus. Okay, let's know who were the disciples of Jesus. Of course, the 12 apostles were disciples. Every apostle was a disciple, but not every disciple was an apostle. Jesus had a lot of disciples. Today, let's reflect upon their reaction after the statement of Jesus saying that they needed to eat on His flesh, to drink on His blood. You know, they were thinking that Jesus was talking nonsense, you know, and they were murmuring. And Jesus knew what they were thinking, you know. Since Jesus knew that, Jesus said to them, "Why are you murmuring? Does that shock you? What if you see the Son of Man going up to the same place where He was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is of no avail." And Jesus is saying that it is not the flesh that is important, but the Spirit that was important. And the words I've spoken to you are Spirit and life. But among you, there are some that don't believe, because Jesus knew from the beginning. Jesus knew who wouldn't believe Him, those who would believe Him, and the one who would betray Him, aka Judas Iscariot. But then Jesus said, like, "I'm not done yet," you know. Jesus simply didn't say that they needed to eat from His flesh, to drink from His blood. Jesus went beyond, saying that He would ascend to heaven. He would go up to heaven. And Jesus goes on saying that this is why I told you that no one can come to Me unless it is granted him by My Heavenly Father. Yeah, as a result, a lot of disciples decided to leave Jesus. They stopped following Him. And yeah, because this word was so hard for them, they said, "This word is too hard for us. How can one accept this word?" And Jesus turned to the 12, now the apostles, asked to them, "And do you also want to leave Me?" And Peter said, "To whom shall we go? Only You, Lord, have the words of eternal life. Now we have come to believe You, and we are convinced that You are the Holy One of God." And then you might wonder, what? That one is the same Peter who denied Jesus later on? 3 times? Yeah, the same Peter. Yeah, he is like one of us, you know. Even though he knew that Jesus was the Holy One of God, later on he would deny Jesus 3 times. And yeah, today we know that to approach Jesus, to come to Jesus, not simply to say, "Oh, now I'm gonna follow Jesus." Understanding comes from spiritual insights, not from, you know, intellectual or physical comprehension. So we need to be dragged by God towards Jesus. And it's not simply to say, "Oh, I'm gonna follow Jesus." Jesus knew the reason why they left Him. How about us? When we listen to the word of God. Is the word of God too hard for us to comprehend? Are we willing to leave all behind and to follow Jesus, or are we coming back to our former way of life and we are denying the word of God because we think that it is too hard for us? Amen. I hope you all have a wonderful Sunday. Remember, God is the God of the impossible. He's always with us. He's the bread of life that came down from heaven, and whoever eats from this bread will live forever. May God bless you all.